Yeah, hey, Brett, President Obama came to Alaska with one eye on Paris, where in December he hopes to secure a binding international climate change agreement, but he may find the sledding tough. President Obama toured a glacier today in Alaska, a different kind of slippery slope, as his administration continues its push for climate change initiatives. Last night, he met with Alaska natives and then addressed a conference of Arctic nations.
I've come here today as the leader of the world's largest economy and its second largest emitter to say that the United States recognizes our role in creating this problem, and we embrace our responsibility to help solve it. And I believe we can solve it.
Scientists say the Arctic has warmed twice as fast as the rest of the nation. Sea ice is arriving later in the fall and melting sooner in the summer. This was one of the worst wildfire seasons on record in the last frontier state. 5 million acres burned, about the size of Massachusetts. But while the Obama administration blames man and the burning of fossil fuels, there is not consensus.
The climate is changing. Yes, man-made emissions are playing a role. What isn't settled is how big of a role that is. And we know that we haven't seen increased surface temperatures over the past 15 to 20 years, and we know that we're not headed towards the catastrophic warming that the administration is trying to project we're headed towards.
The president has called climate change the greatest threat to national security. Secretary of State John Kerry says it's more of a danger than terrorism. But in Alaska, while everyone acknowledges the warming, they also see opportunity. Less sea ice means open shipping lanes, tourism, and oil exploration. But there's a major obstacle. The U.S. has just two operating icebreakers vessels to navigate the dicey new waters. Russia, meantime, has 41. The White House today announced the addition of one icebreaker by 2020.
It's a start, but we need more. You know, as I mentioned, in the Arctic, the icebreakers are seen as the highways of the Arctic. And right now, Russia has superhighways, and we have dirt roads with potholes. The Russians have 40 icebreakers.